हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अनिलराज, वेलकम टू विट्स कनेक्ट। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव सीन व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ सपोर्ट्स एंड व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ बीम्स, एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ लोड्स। सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज विदाउट नोइंग द टाइप्स ऑफ लोड्स वी कॉन्ट एबल टू कैलकुलेट द शेयर फोर्सेस एंड बेंडिंग मोमेंट्स ऑफ द सेक्शंस। So, types of loading is very important. So, what are the types of loads we'll see today, and how many types of loads are there, how it is going to be act. Let's just see. So, my first type is point load. Point load. What is a point load? Point load in the sense, for example, I'm having a beam. I am having a simply supported beam. In this simply supported beam, here W load is acting. So it is acting at particular point. It means it is acting only at this portion or at this point. So this particular point is called as point loads. Or see, let me tell you, I am having a beam or I am having a surface where I am having a ball. See, the intensity of ball is the total circumference intensity of the ball is laying on a particular point, so on the beam. So this is called as a point load. So these are examples of the point load. Point load is nothing but a simple what we call a particular concentrated position only the load is going to be acted. So it is called as a point load. Depending upon the conditions, this point load may be vary. So it may be number will be more. Let this be W1, W2, or W3. Depending upon the conditions of the beams and depending upon the circumstances, the load may be varied, right? It may be the three or more points are there, but still it is called as point loads only. But here number of point loads are there. So the intensity is very clear. See, the load should act at only the single point. It is called as a point load. For example, in your day-to-day life, where you will see this point load? A construction, for example, in the construction of a building, the material is going to be lifted from low level to high level by using cranes. Right, by using cranes, these are going to be lifted from the ground floor to the first floor. For example, when I am pointing out this and when I am lifting this, then what happens here? Only single point my load is acting. It is called as a point load. And one more example, in the sense, in the Ganesh Chaturthi, the what we call the figures of the Ganapati, the statues of the Ganapati are lifted by a small hook. So here only a particular point, only a small load is acting, only a small particular point load is acting over here. It is called as point loads, right? Point load in the sense only particular point that load should be acted, like this. And my next case is uniformly distributed load. Uniformly distributed load. Distributed load, right? Uniformly distributed load, you can write it as UDL. What is uniformly distributed load? Generally, in our day-to-day life, we will see number of live examples of uniformly distributed load. For example, if you see your house, the slab load is uniformly distributed on the beam. The slab load is uniformly distributed on the beam, right? So in any of the houses, you will see this UDL. It means uniformly distributed load, because the slab length is same from this corner to that corner. For example, this is my column and this is my beam, right? In between these two, the slab is there. In between these two, the slab is there. The slab length here, the slab itself, the slab own weight, it will term it as the self weight. See here, it is distributing. It
is called as UDL.
This is the beam, this is the slab load. The slab length is same from one point to the other point which is coming on the beam. The slab is not going to be, if it is 20, throughout the length it will be 20 only. If it is 30, throughout the length it will be 30 only. If it's 15, 15, like this, examples. So, a uniformly distributed load, in the sense completely the load is going to be distributed throughout the section with same intensity. For example, this is my length, between the two, this, and the UDL will be, this is termed as in kilonewton. Per meter, and per point load it is kilonewtons. Right. Particular point only the load is acting, so that's why that is called as kilonewton. Here, throughout the length it is acting, so that's why length is going to be considered. So that's why for the UDL, the units are kilonewton per meter. The load is distributing uniformly throughout the section. It is called as UDL, uniformly distributed load, and the units will be in kilonewton per meter. Next type of load is uniformly varying load. We'll call it as UVL. This is case number 3. This is uniformly varying load. So this is one more case, case number 3, we'll call it as uniformly varying load. Where do you see this type of uniformly varying load, in the sense? For example, I'm having a beam here. My load intensity is going to be changed according to the length. According to the length, when my length is increasing from that support to this support, the load intensity is also changing, right? It means the load is changing completely. Here, first point, in the previous one, the load is uniformly distributed throughout the length. Wherever you see the length, the load is same. Here, the load is different. Here, load is intensity is different. Here, it is different. Here, it is different. It means, so that's why we'll call it as uniformly varying loads. This uniformly varying loads may be mostly seen in sheds. If it is a big type of sheds, in the type of sheds, you can see this type of uniformly varying load reactions. So to pretend from the, what we call supports from the wind pressures, the slopes which are going to be created with the 30 degrees, 6 degrees, 45 degrees, like this. So here the load are not uniformly distributed. This is called as uniformly varying load. So this is also one of the cases. But in general, in practical, you will be having one more case. It is called as moving loads. Moving loads. Where do you see this moving loads? We'll call it as moving loads. This is case number 4. Moving loads, in the sense, the load is going to be moved from one end to the other end. For example, if I take a train, so the train is the best example for the moving loads, because the tracks are laid rigidly. For the platform, the train is going to be moving from one position to the other position. It means the train is traveling from one end to the other end on the track. It means the load is distributing on the wheels. So here the load is moving from one end to the other end. It is called as moving load. But for our considerations, we will discuss only with point loads, uniformly varying load, and uniformly distributed load. Right, these three are the most important, these three will play a most important role in your careers, because you'll be having a lot of problems, you'll be having a lot of informations in any of the competitive exams, you'll be having these kinds of supports, these kind of problems you have to solve. If you are in the diploma, you are in the BTech, MTech, if you go for PhD, whatever you do, but these are necessarily you are going to be remembered, because point load, UDL load, UV load, depending upon the structures you are going to be designed this, right? And how it is going to react and how the loads is going to be distributed, that we will see in the further class also. And before going for that, let us see some definitions of shear force and bending moment, because shear force and bending moments are the major basic definitions of in engineering mechanics. So let's see the definitions of shear force and bending moment. Now let's see the definition of shear force and bending moment. What is shear force? Here is the definition: the algebraic sum of all the forces acting either right or left of the section. It means all the forces should be calculated from the right or from the left, that should be equal. And next, movement in the sense bending moment, the algebraic sum of all the moments acting either right or left of the section. It means movement. See, there is a small major difference between force and moment. Force is nothing but load, only load is going to be calculated. Moment is nothing but load into distance, both will comes into consideration. So here movement is nothing but load into distance, it is termed as movement. Force is nothing but load. Let us see one example for shear force and bending moment. I am having a beam, a simply supported beam. So I am having 3 point loads. Here it is: 2 kilonewtons, 3 kilonewtons and 4 kilonewtons. This is this 2 kilonewtons is acting at a distance of 2 meters. So let this is my beam. This is A, this is B, this is C, this is D and this is E. Now what is shear force? The algebraic sum of all the forces acting either right or left of the section. It means force in the sense, what is the forces here? Here, what are my forces? 2 kilonewtons, 3 kilonewtons and 4 kilonewtons. So 2 plus 3 plus 4. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 4, 9 kilonewtons. So I have calculated from this and I can calculate from this. Right, forces, only am calculating forces. What is force at C in the sense 2 kilonewtons, force at D in the sense 3 kilonewtons, force at E in the sense 4 kilonewtons. It means, so in your problem, what you will do in the sense, first you will find out the reactions. Here Ra should be calculated, here Rb should be calculated, Ra and Rb should be calculated. And after calculating the Ra and Rb, then you will go, you will find out the forces for each particular point, right? So let us see one example for this. One more example. Let me tell you, a simply supported beam, it is having of 10 kilonewton load, right? This is 2 meters, this is 2 meters. So this is A, B, C. Now a simply support beam carries a 10 kilonewtons point load at its center. It means it is called as symmetrical section. It means when I divide the section into two equal parts, the load is also equally distributed. When I divide the section, for example, this is 8, no? When I divide the section here into half, here I am 2, here this side I am having 4, and this 3 is not equally distributed. So you will be having little bit what we call unsimilarities. So you, when you will go for this, so what is Ra here? Equally distributed, no? This is 5 kilonewtons. What is Rb? This is also Rb equal to, reaction at B equal to 5 kilonewtons. So here shear force at A equal to 5, shear force at C equal to top is plus, down is minus, so 5 minus 10, 5, and here it will become 5, like this. So forces in the sense only that particular point, what will be the forces you should be calculating. And let's come to the moments, bending moment. The algebraic sum of all the moments acting either right or left of the section. Moment in the sense, I said earlier, load into distance. For example, I want moment D of C point. So what I do? 2 into 2, right? If I want a particular point at here, then 2 into 4 plus 3 into 2, like this. So this is my load, this is my distance. So both together, it is generating me moment. My moment is going to be generating. So in particular problems, you can calculate the problem from the left side or from the right side. The answer is right. You may calculate it from the right or from the left. So that's why he is saying from the left or from the right, you can solve the shear force and bending moment problem by any sides. You'll get the same answer. You can calculate from the left, or you can calculate from the right. Whatever you calculate, you'll get the same proportional answers. So that's why your definitions are like this. So let's see the shear force and bending moment definitions. The shear force, the algebraic sum of all forces acting either right or left of the section. That may be calculated from the right or from the left. Next, bending moment, the algebraic sum of all the moments acting either right or left of the section. The moments is also CA. See, when I said from here to here, I can go in vice versa, 2 into 2 or 4, 3 into 4, like this. The moments, which direction you take, the answer will be similar. Left or right, you may take according to your convenient, right? Now, in next class, we are going to see some problems on these type of cases. And thank you.